Okay, welcome back guys again. In today's class, we are going to go start off in middle term factorization, which you have already learned in your previous classes. So I'm not going to go deep into this topic. I will just try to solve two or three questions. Exercise 4.2, question number one. Find the roots of the following quadratic equation by factorization. Now guys, in chapter 2, I have already explained to you the meaning of roots, the meaning of zeros are both the same thing. Okay, roots and zeros are the values of x that can be substituted to get the end to satisfy the entire equation. Okay, so exercise 4.2, question number 1, find the roots of the following quadratic equation by factorization. Now see, when they say factorization, they obviously mean middle term factorization. I will take the first question, question number 1, part 1, x squared minus 3x minus 10 equals to 0. Using this data, I have to find the solution of x. So what do I do in middle term factorization first? You will multiply a and c. A is 1 here, c is minus 10 here. Or c is 10 here. So 1 into 10 will be 10. Right? That was your first step. You will multiply a and c, then find out the prime factorization of a and c, then group up the datas. So this becomes x squared. Okay? How will I get 3? I can write 3 as 5 minus 2, x minus 10 equals to 0. So this becomes x squared minus 5x plus 2x minus 10 equals to 0. I hope you understand this part, guys. See, this value you have to break it down. How will I break it down? By multiplying this 2 and by prime factorizing it. Right? When I multiply 10 and 1, there is nothing here, coefficient is 1. When I multiply 10 and 1, I get the answer as 10. After getting 10 as the product, you will try and factorize it. 2 5s are 10, 5 1s are 1. Next step is, whatever factors you got, 2, 5, 1, I have to group it up in such a way so that their addition or subtraction is equal to b. Now I have only two factors here, 2 and 5. If I add it, 2 plus 5, I will never get 3. So what I have to do, 5 minus 2, then only I will get 3. Next step, x minus 5. Plus 2, x minus 5 equals to 0. So this becomes x minus 5, x plus 2 equals to 0. Now see guys, what is the meaning of this bracket? There are two equations here. Product of those two equations are 0. When can you get a product as 0? Only if one of the number is 0. Right? 1 into 0, 0. 2 into 0, 0. One of the number has to be 0 so that the product becomes 0. So it's either this 0 or this 0. So if x minus 5 equals to 0, then x will be what? Plus 5. Or if x plus 2 equals to 0, x will be minus 2. See guys, these are the two roots of the equation. And this is called middle term factorization. Okay? Which question do you want me to do? Actually, all the questions are extremely easy. I will do question number 1, part 3, because there are roots written there, and you guys find root questions a bit tough. So the third question is, root 2x squared plus 7x plus 5 root 2 equals to 0. Now guys, how will I solve it? Like I said, you have to multiply a and c first. If I multiply root 2 and 5 root 2, what will I get? I'll get 10. Yes or no? Yes or no? 5, what is the first step? Multiply a and c. A is root 2 over here. C is 5 root 2 over here. This becomes 5 into root 2 into root 2. 2. Answer is 10. Next step, you have to prime factorize 10. I get 2 and 5. Right? How will I get 7 out of 2 and 5? I will add it. So root 2x squared plus 2 plus 5x plus 5 root 2 equals to 0. I'll open up the bracket, root 2x squared plus 2x plus 5x plus 5 root 2 equals to 0. Next, the common step. What can we make common out of here? I can take x common out of here. This becomes root 2 x plus 2 plus 5 x plus root 2 equals to 0. Guys, see, I can take even root 2 common out of here. So this can become x root 2, x plus root 2 plus 5, x plus root 2 equals to 0. See, make sure that these bracket terms which you are getting are equal. Always, it will always come equal. If it is not coming equal, your answer you have definitely done somewhere wrong. So this becomes x root 2 plus 5 and x plus root 2 equals to 0. So same thing, first equate this as 0, then this as 0. So if x root 2 plus 5 equals to 0, then x will be minus 5 by root 2. This is your first rule. Next, or if x plus root 2 equals to 0, x will be minus root 2, guys. I hope you understood this very easily, because you have, again, like, just like I said, you have already done this method in your previous classes. Okay, guys? Question number 3. Find the numbers whose sum is 27 and the product is 182. So there are two numbers in the question. When you add those two numbers, you are getting 27 as the sum. And when you are multiplying those two numbers, you are getting 182 as a product. So, according to question, question number 3, okay? According to question, product of two numbers is how much? 182. Sum of two numbers is how much? 27. So if the sum of two numbers is 27, let the first number be x. Then the second number, can I write it as 27 minus x, guys? Yes or no? I can write the second number as 27 minus x. Why? Because the sum of these two numbers is 27. Now, according to question, product of two numbers, that is x into 27 minus x, equals to 182. See, guys, why did I take the first number as x and why didn't I take the second number as y? Because this is not linear equation. This is quadratic equation quotients. All the variables are supposed to be same. Meaning, if you are equating in terms of x variable, everything should be in the form of x. If you are equating in terms of y variable or any other variable, everything should be in the form of that particular variable only. You will not mix two variables together. Okay? Solve the question. This becomes 27x minus x square equals to 182. What can I do here? Minus x square plus 27x minus 182 equals to 0. I brought it RHS into LHS. Now see, guys, it's very uncomfortable if you solve minus of ax square. So what will I do? I'll just simply reverse the symbols of the entire equation. How did I do it? It's very simple. See, right hand side there is only 0. If I reverse the symbols of the left hand side, right hand side, there is not going to be any significant change. Okay? Now, by middle term factorization, I have to solve it. How will I solve it? You will multiply 182 into 1, find out the prime factorization, you will observe that you get 14 and 13. Okay? I got two values, one is 14, one is 13. So this becomes x square minus 14x plus 13x plus 182 equals to 0. This is plus? No, this is minus. So what will I do now? X common, x minus 14 minus 13 common, x minus 14 equals to 0. Now guys, I'll rub off the top part once. I hope you have copied it down very nicely. So what did I get? X bracket x minus 14 minus 13 bracket x minus 14. So this becomes x minus 14 into x minus 13 equals to 0. Same way, if x minus 14 equals to 0, then x will be what? 14. Or if x minus 13 equals to 0, the value of x is plus 13. So there, the two numbers are 14 and 13. When you add those two numbers, you are getting 27 as a sum. When you multiply these two numbers, you are getting 182 as the product. Okay, guys? Done? This is question number 3 for you. I'll do one more question, question number 5, which is again extremely easy. But since it's a word problem, the altitude of a right angle triangle is 7 cm less than its base. If the hypotenuse is 13 cm, find the other two sides. So the first most important thing that is given in the question, that it is a right angle triangle. Okay, so in this right angle triangle, which is the altitude? AB is the altitude, BC is the base, AC is the hypotenuse, right? So it's, they have said here that the altitude of a right angle triangle is 7 cm less than its base. So the altitude is 7 cm less than its base. So if I take the base as x centimeter, the altitude will be what? X minus 7 cm, guys, yes or no? Very simple, right? It's given in the question. If the hypotenuse is 13 cm, the hypotenuse is given how much? 13 cm. It's very simple, just use Pythagoras theorem. So given BC equals to x centimeter, AB equals to x minus 7 cm, and AC is 13 cm. Now by Pythagoras theorem, AB square plus BC square equals to AC square. Substitute all the values, you get x minus 7 whole square plus x square equals to 13 square. This becomes x square plus 49 minus 14x plus x square equals to 169. 2x square minus 14x minus 120 equals to 0. See, I solved it, okay? I brought it here and I solved it. Ultimately becomes x square minus 7x minus 60 equals to 0. Guys, you please try to solve this by yourself. It's a very simple thing. What you have to do, you have to measure and factorize it and find the values of x. Okay? X square minus 7x minus 60, then write down the answer in your copy. Okay, now guys, again I am reminding you, exercise, all these questions, okay, 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, you're supposed to do in your copy. Do all the questions, okay? Whatever doubts you have, you can later ask me. So in this class we'll stop it right here. In the next class I'm going to start off with exercise 4.3. Thank you so much.